Hello, everybody! This is Punk Demon Neo, and welcome back to the Banjo-Kazooie playthrough. Last time, we returned to Free ZZ Peak to get the final two Jiggies in that level, and we were successful in doing so. In the process, we also unlocked our next level, Mad Monster Mansion, level 7, and in this episode, or in this recording, I should say, we are going to go ahead and take on level 7 Mad Monster Mansion, and soon we will be approaching the end game, ladies and gentlemen. We are definitely in the later stages of the game, and maybe, just maybe, I can get this playthrough done before the end of the month, and I'll have a clean slate going into the month of May. So first we need to traverse across this room with the instant death magma pit. Or rather, a bottomless pit that's textured to look like magma. And we come across a very spooky area indeed. A graveyard. Not a very cheery or happy place, but this is the location where we will find the entrance to Mad Monster Mansion. However, you want to do a little bit of exploring in this area first, because behind one of the tombstones is actually Brantilda, and speak of the devil. Give me some more trivia, Brinty. As Grunty taunts us. Alright, give me the scoop, Brinty. Did you know Wartbags keeps a loogie-filled hanky in her pocket for luck? That is quite disgusting. I've also seen my sister cuddling a huge, sweaty baboon in bed at night.
Okay then.
She's really proud of her broomstick. It's a top-of-the-range Lardmaster 2000.
Fascinating. Alright, so that's three more pieces of trivia thanks to Brantilda, and it won't be long before we're done talking to her. I think she appears at least two or three more times until we pretty much exhaust everything she has to tell us. Now the first thing you want to do is you want to break down this gate. We can't do anything in the area beyond that gate right now, but trust me, it is a very good idea to break down that gate now so you don't have to worry about it later. And ladies and gentlemen, it begins. It's time for Mad Monster Mansion. One of the more standout levels of the late game of Banjo-Kazooie, and this level, in my opinion, this is the obligatory haunted house ghost type level, much like in the vein of Big Boo's Haunt from Super Mario 64, I guess is the best comparison. And this is probably one of the best levels of that trope that I've at least seen in a video game. I won't say I love Mad Monster Mansion, but it's definitely a very fun, memorable level with some great gimmicks here and there. And it's definitely one of the best haunted house type levels. If I were to do a top 10 spooky levels or haunted levels, this level would probably be somewhere on that list. And we're not gonna waste any time here. We have quite a few areas to cover on the grounds of Mad Monster Mansion. It's not just the mansion itself we have to cover. There are a lot of side areas to this place. This is quite a big and expansive level, so needless to say, we're gonna be here a while. I think I'm gonna focus on the exterior of the mansion itself for the most part, at least in this early part of the recording, and I'll see how far I can get before we have to start going to the side areas. First thing you want to do is you want to break as many windows as you can on the outside of the mansion, because these windows, when you break them, you can go inside the mansion and go into the various rooms. Now this room is the bathroom. We can't do anything in that room for the time being. We're gonna have to come back a little bit later. I do probably need a little bit of a refresher on what each of these rooms are meant to contain. And right here is an empty honeycomb piece that we can't grab at the moment. So that's two rooms now where we can't do anything. Great start to this level. I'll admit I haven't practiced this level prior to this recording, so that's probably going to be a little bit of a hindrance. Alright, if we go up into here, we can find a master bedroom containing some eggs and a Jinjo and also one of these green ghost-type enemies. The best way to deal with the large green ghosts is to attack them with your Wonder Wing. No other attack will affect them. It's either avoid them or use the Wonder Wing. There's nothing in that treasure chest, or so it seems. Okay, so we gotta get on top of the... Let's see, how am I gonna do this? I was going to say perhaps there is a use for this large chest, using it as a springboard, but now that I think about it, there's a springboard right here with this shock jump pad. And there's our first Jinjo. Interesting fact about this picture here that depicts a pirate. This is actually a reference to the very early development of Banjo-Kazooie. Banjo-Kazooie was originally going to be a game called Project Dream. I believe it was supposed to be some kind of RPG. And I think, unfortunately, I cannot remember the name of that pirate character, but I think he was supposed to be one of the key villains in that game, in Project Dream, before it became Banjo-Kazooie. What's interesting is that Banjo himself was in the game as a bear, but he was not the protagonist. I believe he was just a supporting character. And unfortunately, I can't remember the name of who was supposed to be the original protagonist of Project Dream, but that was the game that eventually morphed into Banjo-Kazooie. Banjo-Kazooie had quite the development process. Alright, anything in this room? Seems to be just a bunch of musical notes. And of course, we have a reskin of the giant eel enemies from Clanker's Cavern, but this time they're skeletal enemies popping out of those paintings, but they function the exact same way. Now, if I'm right, we need to drop in here. Alright, so we have this room. The gimmick of this room is pretty interesting. I knew you had to walk through the flames of that fireplace for something, and I messed up. The idea of this room is that you're supposed to hop on the chairs without touching the floor to get on that table, and you don't want to wake up that ghost. Unfortunately, I woke up that ghost, and we have to try this again. That's the first time I've failed. In all my years playing this game, I have never actually failed that. Great time to do it right when I'm recording something and, you know, I don't want to really be failing. Alright, so let's do this challenge properly. The thing is, you need to get onto the table without waking up the ghost and then simply walk through his body and you'll get the jiggy. Grunty's gold, how it shone. She'll be mad. Now it's gone.
Yes, I'm mad. My boot I'll put up your useless spooky butt.
God almighty. Nearly 11 minutes into the recording and we just now get the first jiggy. That does not speak well to the progress I'm going to be making here. But after overcoming initial difficulties, we managed to get Jiggy number one, and the inside of this mansion's big enough that we can actually fly around through it, and we can actually get a look at some of the paintings here. So let's see what we got here. We have a picture of Klungo, Grunty's minion, Gruntilda herself, Dingpot, her cauldron, Brentilda. Very interesting that she would have a picture of her, exterior of her lair, her broomstick, and interestingly enough, Mumbo Jumbo. And that's pretty much it for the dining room in the interior of the mansion. Now I think it's time we start focusing on the outer areas. We start branching out a little bit here, because we still have a lot of ground left to cover if we plan on getting through this stage. But first, some more vandalism, just because. And let's see where we can go here. Well, first we can get some musical notes, and we can break open that gate that will bring us to a chapel. And you want to be on your guard for these skeleton guys. They can be a bit of a hassle because it seems to be they're like the mummies from Gobi's Valley. I think the only way you could truly kill them is by attacking them with the Wonder Wing. But I want to hold on to my gold feathers because we're going to be dealing with those ghosts later on. So yeah, I want to hang on to my gold feathers for when we have to deal with more of those green ghosts, so I think I'm going to be better off just avoiding these guys. But I got to be careful of my health as well. Even with my health expanded, I still need to be careful not to take too many hits. Okay, let's start succeeding in this level with another little minigame type stage. But first, let's go ahead and grab these musical notes while they're still out here. And let's see what's going on here. Greetings, O Solid One. I'm Tumblr the Mighty. Solve the puzzle, and you can take this infernal thing that's stuck under me. Sounds like a good deal. Alright, so this is another spelling minigame. Much like the sandcastle in Treasure Trove Cove, we need to spell out Banjo-Kazooie while moving along on this large board. I forget what this is called, this type of setup here, moving this little thing around. I actually don't know what this is called at all, to be perfectly honest, but basically we just move along, hitting the different letters until we spell Banjo-Kazooie. Pretty simple idea. Although I feel like this could have done with your platform here moving just a bit quicker, but that's just me. The camera angle doesn't help either. This is sort of a fixed camera, and it's a bit irritating having to make sure that I don't back up onto a Gruntilda spot. Also, you want to watch it with that ghost because it can knock you off and cost you time. So I guess that's something else to be concerned about. Because you can't really defend yourself when you're on this thing. Banjo seems to be locked into this pose. At last, the puzzle is solved! Take this thing! I'm leaving this gloomy shed! At least we got the job done. But I was cutting it close with that timer. You have just enough time to make it through that challenge. It's a lot like some of the other timer challenges where you have just enough time, especially some of the challenges in the later stages. Break down another gate. Seems I think we have a bit of a fountain area here. Yes, we do. And let's see what we can grab over here. Looks like we got another Jinjo. This will be our third Jinjo, so at least we're making progress on that front. And that was a long jump that we had to complete with that shock jump pad. Alright, so we have yet another timing challenge. See that timer? 14 seconds, and you need the speed shoes, the running shoes, in order to get this done. And even then, you have just enough time. Get to the chapel! Literally 1 second on the clock. You cannot dilly-dally. And we are inside the chapel, ladies and gentlemen. This is almost an entire level in and of itself. The things we need to watch out for here are the green ghosts again. But if we give them a nice taste of our Wonder Wing, they'll go away and they won't be a problem. Which I can certainly get behind. I can certainly endorse that. Looks like there's only two. There's only one other that I see. I need to get him in position so I can take him out as well, so there won't really be anything to hinder us. See ya! And I should have a few gold feathers left for the remaining ghost encounters if I can't just avoid them. Luckily, there's no challenge involving destroying those guys, so you don't have to worry about going through a gauntlet of them or anything. And I have to give this part of the level points for the music track. This very mournful, haunting rendition of the main level theme as played on a pipe organ. Very appropriate, because we have a pipe organ as the centerpiece of this section of the level. So definitely you gotta give this part of the level points for atmosphere. There's a very nice atmosphere in this part of the level. Now before we get to the organ itself... Okay, looks like it's just beehives. We don't really have to worry about that. I'm in pretty good condition as far as health is concerned. Now if I can just get... No! If I can get my button combinations right! Alright, let's see what's going on here. Gotta go a little bit further, and up to here. Mutzant plays his organ with ease, but can you follow him on the keys? Alright, so we have a bit of a... Not necessarily a rhythm challenge, but more of a... follow the hand challenge, I guess. Basically, whatever key Mutzant presses, you want to press as well. Or is it pronounced Mutzant? It's probably pronounced Mutzant, since it's supposed to be a reference to Mozart. I'm guessing that's the reference being made here. Not bad, Bear, but now watch me. Copy this tune, and amazed I'll be. This isn't too hard. I'm no musician, but I kind of enjoy this little challenge. He's focusing on the black keys at first, but here we go. I can tell you one thing, I'm certainly no pianist. I have no idea how to play a piano. Or any musical instrument for that matter. Boom! Your music skills are mighty fine, so take this golden piece of mine. Alright, so we earned our haunting music credentials, I guess. Not every day you play piano with a disembodied ghost hand, am I right? Of course, now we have to actually get to the jiggy, but we can grab a golden banjo for an extra life. Not that that's gonna matter, because I'm gonna be turning off the system after this recording, but it's the thought that counts. There we go, and off we go, getting these remaining... getting these remaining items. Lost my train of thought there for a second. I was like, I'm supposed to be talking about something, but what? Now we need to get to this flight pad, because we can actually go up into the rafters of the chapel. And it's a good thing I grabbed some of those red feathers in the outside areas, because now we need to take flight. And I almost... That could have been a disaster. I did not land myself in a good spot right there. I was just on the edge of the platform. I should have gone plummeting down to the floor. That would have been quite a messy ending. But there is our first empty honeycomb piece of the level. Yes, we can still collect those. We still have one last set to collect before those are considered done. Now let's see if I can... You gotta use the center camera around Banjo trick by holding the R button so you can safely navigate across. And what do you know? Here's our Gruntilda switch. Should be interesting trying to get that jiggy. Now let's see. I think I can just simply drop off. Good thing I activated my second jump when I did, or, you know, we would have gone curse splat. And that would not have been a good ending. And I think that just about does it inside the chapel. I think we've collected everything in here. So let's get on out of here and back to the outside. But now we can take care of business on the exterior here in the cemetery. You want to be careful because there are tombstones that are actually enemies that will pop up and try to attack you. Now, what we can do in this area is we can shoot eggs into these flower pots scattered throughout the level. Problem is, the game can be a little finicky if you don't place yourself exactly right. This is actually one of the more annoying bits of the level because of how you have to position yourself. Because for some reason, I can't just shoot them into the thing, they'll bounce off. Now, when you successfully get the egg into the flower pot, the flowers will sprout and a voice will say, "Thank you." And yes, it is saying thank you. It is not saying a certain F word. Although it is a bit hard to make out at first. See, look at that. It was like I was just off a tiny bit and the egg bounced off the rim.
Thank you.
Nothing but net on that last one, though. Really?
Thank you.
And that one decided to bounce off the flower pot. I'm telling you, getting this done can be a bit finicky. But, and that one bounced off and back into my inventory. See, this one's just weird. But there's our jiggy! Yes, son! Now we're making progress with these jiggies. Also, you can actually jump into this window right here, into a small area. Okay, be careful because the monsters will still pop out of the pictures. There doesn't seem to be anything in here other than supplies, so this is basically a resupply room in case you need it. Still a pretty nice thing to have, you know. And another gate that we need to break down. And before we do anything else, we need to get on top of the chapel. Because, of course, we would have to do so. First, we need to get some musical notes. Still need to be collecting those, although I say we're making some pretty good progress on that front. And up to the clock tower, and I'm not talking about the old horror series of games. Step into this opening and we'll actually be taken to the top of the tower. And I'm trying to be very careful so I can grab these musical notes without overshooting my jump and falling off to the very bottom. That would not be something that I want to have happen. And shock jump, and up here is another jiggy. We're definitely racking them up now. And we can also get a good view of the property here. We got the mansion, we got the shed, we got a little courtyard area with some fountains. We got Mumbo's skull hut. Yes, Mumbo is in this level, which means we have another transformation. And we still have this hedge maze that we still have to do. So there's definitely still some ground to cover. And I should point out, there is still some stuff in the interior of the mansion, which we still have to get done. So by no means are we done. Although, we are making good progress.
Thank you.